Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. I know it's been a while. I missed you. And that's actually because I've just taken this time to kinda pump the brakes on my channel and just kinda recoup mentally. I'm just kidding. It was because my hair was too long. 2 weeks went by and I was like, I should film a video. And that, by that time I was like, I already had a haircut scheduled for a week later, as the earliest. And then I was like, I'm not filming with my long ass hair. That's every time I do that, and I think it looks fine, I look back on it in my videos, and it's the ugliest thing ever. So anyways, maybe I just didn't need to say any of that.
You didn't.
I have been lately on a little Red Bull kick. I could not tell you why. I think it's placebo though. I'm either getting addicted or it's placebo. So I thought it'd be really funny to make a, I've been trying to make a Red Bull video for a bit now about what I couldn't tell you that was why I couldn't. Oh, I have to take a quiz. Wait, sorry. I'm doing driver's ed right now, and I'm...
Yeah, baby!
So anyways, Red Bull or whatever. I wanna drink a Red Bull as I'm... I'm gonna start that over. I wanna take my heart pressure and my heart rate, and then drink a Red Bull, and then do it again, and see if it changes. Because it's supposed to have, like, drastic effects on you within, like, 90 minutes or something. And I think that'd be really funny, because my mom, it's a battle between me and my mom about Red Bull. She sends me all these forums about kids dying after drinking one Red Bull or whatever, like, Facebook type, like, post that would be. She's just, like, worried, because it is, like, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying Red Bulls and energy drinks aren't dangerous. There's obviously a limit and, like, a cap. The ones I get are the 8-ounce ones, which are, like, 76 grams of caffeine, which is below the recommended amount for teens. As she should be, right? Like, energy drinks and stuff like that can be really scary sometimes. So, I thought it'd be funny to go right up to the limit and see how far I can push it. Recently, Rite Aid brought back their 3-for-5 deal because literally every single time I start taking advantage of Rite Aid's deals, they take it away because of me. But now it's back. So I bought 3 little Red Bulls yesterday, blueberry, pomegranate, and watermelon. So we're gonna see which one. Actually, we're not. This is up to me. We'll go watermelon. I haven't had it in a bit, so. Ow, it's cold. That was cute. One of these leaves was blocking the camera screen. It was a little too much for me and my little heart to handle. Speaking of hearts being able to handle things, let's go measure my blood pressure. Or whatever, shut up, I don't know, heart rate. Wait, I was kind of like running around. I should like chill for a bit. I apologize if this video is all over the place. I actually don't care. Just make your own video. Okay, I'm good guys. We're gonna be drinking a nice watermelon Red Bull today. But before we try it, here's a word from today's sponsor. This is one I'm curious about. Coconut has been a topic of discussion in my brain, taste buds, for a good time. This is literally like the last Red Bull flavor I need to try, I'm pretty sure. There's like Red Bull Zero and then like Red Bull Sugar Free, but like of the flavored ones, this is the last one. And they were all good. Like I would buy all the other ones again. This one though, most of the time it tastes like shampoo or like conditioner, you know? I don't know how I feel about that. Bye. It's good, cool. So Several studies in healthy adults have shown that drinking one 12-ounce can of Red Bull significantly increases blood pressure and heart rate levels within 90 minutes.
Cool.
I had a dream that I thought while the Red Bull is kicking in, this would be a good time to educate myself on the dangers of drinking a Red Bull while I'm drinking a Red Bull. But
energy drinks,
supersized, grab and go ready, and
turbocharged with caffeine. They are the fastest growing beverage in the soft drink industry.
I like the taste of them, but also just feel more alert and focused when I take them.
That extra boost comes from caffeine, the most popular drug in the world.
Second to happiness.
But an increasing number of young people are getting their caffeine from
chemical-loaded energy drinks.
I don't really like.
But what's actually in these drinks?
Happiness.
Often there are other ingredients besides caffeine, which sometimes may build up the effect of the caffeine.
Classified as a dietary supplement, energy drinks are unregulated.
Companies can put in whatever they want. They don't have to say how much caffeine is in it. It's never checked by the FDA. And so when you drink that can, you're really not sure what you're drinking.
The consumption of
this could say battery acid.
Energy drinks is a rising public health concern.
High blood pressure, rapid heartbeats, premature beats, experience mood changes and seizures.
And COVID-19.
And people can end up with acute kidney injury and renal failure.
Guys, kidney injury is not cute. Sorry.
And people can end up with acute kidney injury and renal failure.
It's funnier that I replayed it.
Have you ever mixed it with alcohol by any chance?
No, that's, I've heard that's not too great for you at all.
He just had a spark in his eye. He 100% tried it right after this interview.
What a day for America. Red Bull winter flavor. Who would have thought of something so innovative and pioneering? I just got this in a PR package. It was really nice. I'm actually one of the first people to try the flavor. Red Bull's DMing me. We've been talking for a bit, and they told me about this a little while back. And that's kind of why I started to get into Red Bull. And so then they were like, next month we're releasing winter edition. What's your info and stuff? Do you want us to send you one? And I was like, yes, obviously. So I didn't know what flavor it was going to be, though. It's pomegranate. What a world this is. I haven't thought about what it could taste like until just now. And I'm so excited. Just saying this because they sponsored this and they sent it to me. This is the greatest Red Bull out of all the flavors. It's greater than Peach Red Bull. Y'all would never think I'd say that. I told myself, it's 9:20. I don't really need this for anything. I mean, like, I still have homework and stuff, but I can finish it in a reasonable time. I'm not going to drink the Red Bull. I'm just going to have a little taste test because I'm eager and for the video. I want to finish it. I will say my heart's beating irregularly fast. I usually, like, I get a lot of chest pain from drinking Red Bull, but this one's making my heart, like, beat especially fast. It feels, like, hard to breathe.
You only get one heart. You shouldn't fool around with it.
But what would happen if you only drank energy drinks?
You would be immortal. If you guys think I should try reaching immortality, hit the like button. I think I'm good on Red Bull PSAs. I feel like all these videos are, like, trying to hint at Red Bull being not too good for you. It's been about, like, 20 minutes. I'm gonna measure. It went down. My heart rate went down after drinking Red Bull.
Next up is taurine, an organic acid found in animal tissue. German scientists discovered the stuff in ox bile in 1827, naming it for the Latin taurus, or bull.
I'm a Taurus. Maybe that's why it's not affecting me, because this stuff that it's made from is the same thing I made from, since I'm a Taurus and it's taurine. So it like cancels out.
In quantity, this meat sugar, as it's sometimes called, reduces depression, panic attacks, agoraphobia, and OCD. To get those effects from Red Bull, you'd need to drink about 360 cans a day.
Done, I'll do it. Oh no, not someone's own video filmed on iPhone. That's scary. I feel like he's actually gonna like die on camera.
Hey guys, welcome to my vlog.
He's like,
what's up guys? I just actually had a heart attack.
What the hell? There cannot possibly be a video more 2009 than what I just watched. I think that was probably the most informal video out of all the ones I've watched. Oh, I should add an emoji. That's it. I'm done. I'm ending the video. Moral of the story. Why are people surprised when it's like, what's Red Bull made of? And it's like, gray acid number 5. Like, what did you expect to be in it?